Surf Lifesaving Australia has announced a raft of new safety measures, including the compulsory use of helmets and life jackets in competitions. Amber Austin-Wright has followed the campaign for better protection, and she joins us now from the Gold Coast. Amber, what's led to these tougher rules?
Georgie, the lifesaving movement has been under immense pressure over the death of competitors at the Australian Surf Lifesaving Championships here on the Gold Coast. Last year, the competition was moved further south to Kira, where the conditions are less treacherous, and now there's been even more changes. Surf lifesaving bosses say they're confident these new measures will save lives.
They know the surf better than anyone, but even the country's best lifesavers are no match for conditions like this. In 17 years, three young lives have been lost in competition. Now Surf Lifesaving Australia is changing the rules to prevent any more deaths.
The surf can be dangerous at times, and it does continually change. So our safety responses, and in this case in the terms of equipment or other conditions we apply, have got to be responsive to those changes.
15-year-old Robert Gattenby drowned in cyclonic surf at Kurrawa Beach in 1996. He'd been racing surf boats when he was struck by an oar.
We'll be mandating the wearing of helmets on all surf boat rowers as of 1 January 2014.
Soon, all surf lifesavers in inflatable rescue boats will also be required to wear life jackets.
There's a new generation coming through who will embrace it, but yeah, it's a little bit of a pill to swallow for the old brigade.
Last year, 15-year-old Matthew Barclay died after he was knocked unconscious from his board. His father is pleased with the organisation's new focus on safety.
And Steve's very, very much active in these changes. He talks to SLSA quite regularly.
19-year-old Saxon Bird tragically lost his life after he was knocked out by a ski during his event in 2010.
So far, the only safety changes for ski and board riders has been the introduction of high visibility vests. And past champions say the new measures don't go far enough.
I think one of the big things they have to probably look at is actually making the skis a lot lighter.
But they say the changes are a step in the right direction.
The organisation is also making it compulsory to have a bronze medallion at the championships from 2015, but surf lifesaving bosses say it's not possible to completely eliminate risks in the surf environment, Georgie.